Furthermore, she was the fourth woman today to tell me she'd been subpoenaed.
Mr. Schuyler, I have to talk to you.
I don't want her on the stand. Listen, if you haven't got the guts to handle this the right way, I'm going to find someone who does.
Oh, Mr. Schuyler.
I was just going to call you. Get Miss Cutwater's files. Go out to the house. Edwina claims that she's finally dying and needs to get her affairs in order.
No. I have to discuss my future here with you right now.
Well, Roger, we are discussing your future. You're going out to Edwina Cutwater's house.
I want a partnership.
Listen, the day you give up bebop and concentrate on the law, we'll talk.
We'll start talking. I quit the band. As of today, I'm dedicating myself full time to my legal career. Later today, I'm going to buy a vest.
My God, you're serious.
I am serious. But I want to start handling real cases, the big cases. No more of this trick-or-treat stuff.
Roger, you don't know how long I have waited to hear you say those words.
Yeah, but going out to Edwina Cutwater's house is
not right. No, listen to me. Long after Edwina is gone from this earth, her estate is going to generate more income for this office than most small countries see in a year. And it's going to take a lot of very sophisticated legal expertise to structure and administer those affairs. Now, you do this for me today. Go out to her house, and I'll put you in charge of all that. Now, if that's not real law, if that's not big law, I don't know what the hell is.
And actually, the more I think about this thing, the better it sounds. Don't look at me like that, will you? I'm not going in there as a messenger boy. I'm going in as a highly skilled legal advisor. This is really good. No more being looked down upon by people who think they're better than I am because they're rich. From now on, I'm going to be respected by people who think they're better than I am because they're rich.
Hi, Roger Cobb from Schuyler & Mifflin. I see Miss Cutwater.
Yes, sir. You are expected.
I'll show him up.
Thank you.
Betty Adams.
I'm Roger Cobb.
Trying not to excite her, okay?
Grayson? Oh, Grayson?
Yes, madam.
Don't forget to pick up the invitations and make sure they're hand-delivered the moment I die.
The moment you die? Yes, madam.
Oh, Mr.
Cobb.
Cobb. Oh, yes, you're the tedious one. Would you mind accompanying me back to my desk there? Yeah. Now, here's the name of my caterer. And the evening's menu, make sure they include plenty of goose pate. It's marvelous.
This is for the funeral?
One does not have goose pate at a funeral. Now, Mr. Fulton Norris has a wonderful society orchestra. I should like you to engage him for the entire weekend.
This is a wake, then?
Heavens no, it's for a party, and I want it to be a corker. Guess what I'm going to do?
What?
I'm going to come back from the dead.
Oh. And, what makes you think you can do that?
Because I'm rich. Grayson, come in here, please. Over.
Miss Cutwater, this is not a parking ticket we're talking about here. This is the Grim Reaper. You cannot bribe the Grim Reaper.
Oh, Mr. Cobb. I spent a lifetime shackled by frailty and poor health, wheelchairs and sick beds. It's my heart, you see. It means well. But it's always been something of a lemon. I've had all the money in the world and not one good chance to enjoy it. I have never been to Europe. I've never been anywhere, really. Oh, sure, I've ordered from Neiman's and Gucci's, but I've never actually been there. I've never ridden my horses. I've never been to the ballet. I've never danced. But Cutwaters aren't quitters. So I've decided that if my wealth cannot help me in this life, then by God, it's going to buy me another one. Ah, Grayson.
You, walkie-talkied, madam?
Yes, please send in Mr. Prokolosa and what's her name, Fred's daughter.
Miss Terry, madam.
Gas me.
Excuse me, am I just getting you goose pate, or do you have any legal work for me?
Of course I do. I need you to amend my will so that, what's her name, Fred's daughter will become inheritor for my entire estate. So we must draw up a new codicil. We need it witnessed. Ah, your grace.
Oh, you're not.
It's That's all right, Praka.
All right.
Come in. No, come in. Martin. Come in. Come in. Come, come.
Come on. Namaste.
What's going on here?
Wait.
Who's Fred's daughter?
Hello.
Hello, I'm Terry Hoskins.
Roger Cobb. So, you're Fred's daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Who in the heck is Fred?
Daddy, come in, please.
Oh, I'm against the old thing, I am.
My father is Miss Cutwater's stableman.
It's unnatural.
Let me get something straight here. You're going to will all your money to the stableman's daughter, and he's against it.
No.
But he just said that
you
he
see,
was...
I should inherit nothing.
But you just said you wanted to make her your sole beneficiary.
That is correct.
So you will inherit the estate?
No, she won't.
What am I missing here?
You see, thanks to His Holiness Prakalaza, I'm going to be transmigrated.
What?
Transmigrated means that my soul is going to leave my body forever and become one with the universe.
At which time my soul will enter her body.
Ah, good plan.
I'm sorry, but I don't think it's a good plan at all. My daughter's soul leaving her body and going off to who knows where.
Fred, let's not go through all this again, shall we?
Well, I know I wasn't much of a father to her when she was growing up, but I won't lose her again now, I won't.
Zip it, Fred.
Miss Cutwater, as your attorney, it is my duty to inform you that your will could be contested if you're deemed not of perfectly sound mind.
Why, you presumptuous ambulance chaser. Are you insinuating that I am not of perfectly sound mind?
No, no, I wouldn't do that, but I think practically everybody in the solar system would.
Mr. Cobb, the last thing I need around here is your ill-informed negativity. Get out.
Thanks for not exciting her. Don't breathe. It's unnatural. Terry.
No, Praga, not yet. Praga, not yet. I'm all right.
There.
I'm not ready.
Is everybody here bananas?
Mr. Cobb, let me explain something to you. You see... Closer, please. That's for bananas. Now get out.
What century is this?
Now you've hurt my hand. I'm going to tell Mr. Schuyler that you're an insolent little toad and demand that he fire you.
Why don't you just enter his body and do it yourself?
And don't you come back, you peasant!
Look, lady, just because my grandfather didn't rape the environment and exploit the workers doesn't make me a peasant. And it's not that he didn't want to rape the environment and exploit the workers. I'm sure he did. It's just that as a barber, he didn't have that much opportunity.
Grayson, bring the car and my hairdresser and the gold and diamond jewelry. Over. Over.